Hi, I'm Jayme Lewis, and welcome back to LA Bass Licks. Today I got something really fun we're going to do. I'm going to teach you how to play the Ice Bucket Groove. And if you're wondering, what's the Ice Bucket Groove? Well, that's the song that you play while your brother dumps freezing cold water on you. Yeah, it wasn't really the proudest moment in my career, but it was kind of the only way that I knew how to respond to the Ice Bucket Challenge of 2014. So anyways, after I posted that video, people were asking, like, hey, what were you playing? How did you do it? So that's what I'm going to do right now. I tabbed it out for you. You can download the PDF file. It should be just below this video. Follow along, and I'm just going to kind of, you know, describe some of the things that I was doing and walk you through it. One thing I'd like to say beforehand, you'll notice this is the exact bass that I used in that video, and lo and behold, it still works. So if you've ever wondered, hey, will my bass still work if it gets all wet? Well, actually, hold on. Don't blame me. Don't hold me accountable for if you drop your bass in the pool or whatever. But it just had to dry. I mean, you saw it in the video. It stopped working while I was playing it, and I thought it was toast, which is why I did it on this little $100 Squire clunker bass. But after just a couple hours of drying out, I plugged it in, and it started working again. So go figure. Anyways, let's just jump right in. I'll play that intro. What was it? Okay, and the thing about this, it doesn't have to be played rhythmically in time. I mean, you can see if you look at the transcription, like quintuplet 16th notes, and like I was just trying to make sense of what I was doing because there was no meter yet. Again, just kind of take your time with it. I'll play it for you in slow motion. Right? That pattern gets repeated again down a string. And we just add that little tail to it. Just trying to get us into this. Right. And it's a pretty interesting groove, something along the lines of what like Victor Wooten would play, and I'll tell you why. Because all the notes that you're hearing, my thumb and my plucking finger are never attacking. In other words, like the pitches you're hearing, that's all being done with left hand hammer-ons. My right hand is actually kind of like playing the drum beat behind it, right? So again, if you look at the transcription, you're gonna see, you know, T's for thumbs, P's for plucks, F for flicks, and those are pretty much the three percussive sounds that I'm making. Just those three sounds. So ghosted thumps, ghosted plucks, and ghosted flicks. And again, I'm just trying to sound like a drum set when I'm doing that stuff. So I'll walk that through in super slow motion for you. Check it out. I'm doing... Okay, remember how I said I never play the notes with my thumb? That's the only time I play notes with my thumb. I'm using these two fingers. And I'm not so much thumping as much as I am just playing the note with my thumb and plucking the note with my first finger. Right. And just those two tritones, right, just moving down. I'll do it again in slow motion from the top. Okay, now there's another video here on LA Bass called Leading with the Left Hand, and that'll help you out with executing this whole technique. So it's the same technique, just a different groove. But anyways, that's the Ice Bucket Challenge groove. I hope you liked it. Practice up, and we'll see you next time, okay?